Alright, time for the last part of this aberration series. Moving objects do not appear where they are, check. We do not see stationary objects where they are when we are moving, check. Straight lines become curved when we accelerate, check. Why the curved lines are hyperbolas, not checked. That is the goal of this video. In the process, we introduce a neat little viewpoint into the relativity using Lorentz transformations in 2 plus 1 spacetime. Let's go. Time is always passing by, and in spacetime, it is literally passing by. Even as we are immobile in space, we are still moving in time. Let us therefore exchange one spatial dimension for the dimension of time. In this new view, up is the future. Down is the past. And horizontal is the present. Next, let us see how other objects will appear in this 2 plus 1 spacetime. These shiny orbs are stationary with us in space, but in spacetime they trace out lines, their so-called world lines. Collectively, their paths can be seen as a vertical plane. But no observer can ever perceive the entire world lines at once, only slices of them. In a simulation, however, we can picture them as a whole, to gain some understanding of relativity and Lorentz transformations. Now, imagine us traveling through the space-time with this little rocket again. These clocks are horizontally synchronous in this starting frame of ours. And the purple grid levels are planes of instantaneous simultaneity in this particular frame. Now let's see what happens as we start shifting inertial frames. The planes tilt, turning the clocks asynchronous in our new frame. This is the effect of Lorentz transformation. Once again we can see that clocks ahead of us are ahead in time too, and clocks behind us are also behind in time. In a previous video we saw the effect in a more familiar representation. As a reminder, here's how it looks without the vertical time dimension. Here's a side view. Note that we seem to be getting nowhere, although we accelerate. From our own perspective, we are always just moving up. Yet we are getting somewhere, so to speak. The space levels skew to the opposite direction, making us effectively move forward with respect to the original coordinates. The skew effect is perhaps easier to observe with Galilean transformations, but note, they do not tilt the planes of simultaneity. Let us see what acceleration does for stationary objects and formations. The green lines are world lines of some particles which are stationary in this starting frame. But as we accelerate, the Lorentz transformation tilts the plane, having the effect that although we seem to be continuing directly up, we still eventually cross these world lines. Let's take another example. In this case, the Lorentz transformations neatly fold the space-time, allowing us a little round trip, while ever only going up in our own frame. From the outsider's perspective, our little trip looks like this. At this point, I would like to note that our rocket is an exception to our representation of space-time objects. To be truthful to our representation, we would have to draw the entire world line of the rocket. But for artistic and illustration purposes, we choose not to. and draw the rocket as if it was cruising around in this 2 plus 1 spacetime. For comparison, here's the same maneuver with Galilean transformations. Next, we shall consider the light cones and what we would actually see and perceive. The past light cone shows us the section of spacetime we can receive information from at any particular instant. And at any instant, we can actually see infinitely many slices of space taken at a different time in the past. For example, we would not see these purple grid lines as straight grid lines. We would see each grid as a thin slice radiating outwards from us. Information from the more distant regions of the plane would be received later than information from the nearer regions of the plane. This would make us see a single synchronous plane in spacetime, like one of these purple grids, as an expanding ring. Let us next look at the line formation of stationary objects. The world lines of the stationary objects will form a conical section with the light cone. In spacetime, this is a hyperbola. However, it does not yet look like one in the eyes of the rocket. This is because the rocket will not see the time dimension. Its worldview is the projection of its light cone to its space plane. Projected to the space plane, the spacetime hyperbola will look like a straight line. However, if the rocket is moving, the Lorentz transformation has tilted the world lines. Result is another conical section. And this time the projection to the space does not look straight. Indeed, in this case the rocket will see the moving formation as a hyperbola. Although the formation itself is still a straight line, or in spacetime, a plane. So this is one way to understand why straight lines look hyperbolic for a moving observer. World lines and light cones create conic sections, which in this case tend to be hyperbolas. However, I cannot resist taking another well-known conic section. If you move faster than light, the planes of simultaneity have tipped over so hard the conical sections are now ellipses. So, if you somehow manage to move superluminally, then you would see straight lines as ellipses. And that's always good to know, right? As long as the speed of light is finite, the Galilean transformation will also produce conical sections, although omitting the component from the length contraction. So I guess in this sense, the effect of aberration is not reserved to only Einsteinian relativity. Again, thanks for watching. If you want to support this channel, consider subscribing and liking. And please leave suggestions if you want to see more videos. Thanks, see you, bye.